So hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. I hope you guys are doing great. So in this video we are going to talk about how we can add the lighting into our scene, because last three previous video we already talked about how we can model, how we can add the material into our different parts and sections, and we already talked about how we can add the shape key into our model as well. So if you guys haven't watched three videos yet, so make sure you watch this tutorial first then come here, because that will be a final tutorial about it. And after that we'll start a new series again and we'll just start something else. Maybe we'll start a how we can create a torso for any cartoon head, yeah, maybe we'll just create how we can create a realistic eyes and how we can create a realistic hair as well. So for these tutorials make sure you stay tuned with me and subscribe my channel also. So now let's start your tutorial. So first of all I just want to start a new project file. Alright guys, here you can see we have a new project file, and last previous video we just talked about how we can add the shape keys. Here you can see we have perfectly added the shape key into our scene. So right now I'm just gonna close her mouth, something like that. I think that's look nice to me. Okay, so for creating the any kind of lights, first of all you need some backdrop. So we'll just create a first of all a backdrop. So for creating a backdrop I'm just gonna use a basic shapes. It will be plane basically, so I'm just gonna scale this plane something like that. So always make sure whenever you do scale your object, so make sure you apply the scale first of all, because if you not apply the scales, so maybe in the future you will get some problems when you add any modifier, when you add the bevels, okay, you will not get a desirable results. So make sure whenever you do scale your object, so you apply the scale as well. So okay, so we just scale our plane something like that, and after that I'm just gonna edit mode of this plane, and I'm just gonna extrude this this edge basically. Okay, and after doing the scale I'm just gonna select this middle edge. I will just do Control B. This will be create a little bevelness into our plane, and after that I'm just gonna scroll my mouse wheel something like that, and here you can see we can add lots of edge loop in between here, and now here you can see we have a perfect backdrop here, and after that I'm just gonna shade smooth something like that. Okay, and I'm also gonna enable my shortcut VR so you guys can easily see which key I'm pressing on the right hand side. Yeah, cool. So first of all I'm just gonna switch my scene into our rendering mode. So right now here you can see we have a point light. I'm just gonna delete this point light, and we'll also change our render engine as a EV2 cycle, yeah, and we'll just change our device as a GPU. If you don't have a GPU, so you can use the CPU as well, and we'll also enable our denoising, render denoising as well, and we'll just use as a optics because I have a RTX graphic card, and we'll also enable the viewport denoising as well. So now here you can see we did some render setting as well. So now we'll just add some lighting into our scene. So for adding the light I will not use exact light from here basically. What I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna add the plane again, and I will just scale this plane something like that. Okay, as I told you, whenever you do scale make sure you apply the scale first of all, and I'm just gonna keep this plane top of her head something like that. And before adding the light, first of all I'm just gonna set up on camera views. Okay, so I just want that view should be converted into a camera view, so I will just press the Control Alt 0, and then I'm just gonna my render properties, and here I will just change the little dimension of this. I think I will add the 720 and 1080. I think that's so nice to me, and I will just press the N and go to my view section, and here I'm just gonna unlock my camera. So we'll just move our character or model in a camera view as well. I think that's look nice to me. And after confirming your camera view, make sure you lock your camera, so now it will not move your camera view. Here you can see. Okay, so everything is look nice to me. Now I'm just gonna split this window something like that. Okay, and I'm just gonna do a little zoom in so we can easily see. Okay, and we'll just disable this overlay as well. Now I will just select my plane, and I will just go to my material section, and here I'm just gonna add a new material, and I will just give this name as a light, yeah, something like that, and I will just change the surface as a emission. So that is the emission basically, and here you can see when I just add the surface as an emission, so we'll see little light into our scene, and which is look nice. So we can just increase the strength from here. Here you can see, so we'll just keep this strength as a 2.5 for now. And now I'm just gonna duplicate this plane pressing the Shift D, and I'm just gonna rotate this something like that, and I will just keep this plane behind this camera. Yeah, I think that's looking nice. And now what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna add the base color for this backdrop. So I will just choose the color from here, So let's see which color is look nice in our case. I think purple is also look nice to me. Yeah, so we can take a purple as well. Yeah, that's look nice. And we'll just increase little roughness from here. Yeah, so now here you can see that color is also look nice to me. Now I'm just gonna add a one more light which is gonna enhance our whole scene. So which light I'm gonna add? Basically I'm just gonna add a back light. So what will exactly happen when I add the back light? So here you can see in the corners of these shapes, basically you will get little volume. Okay, you will able to see little volume here. So here you can see when I'm just gonna add a back light. So I will just use a area light for this, and I'm just gonna scale it little bit up, and I'm just gonna, so I will just rotate it manually. Yeah, and I'm just gonna do a little scale and keep it here, and do little manual scale as well. I'm just gonna scale it something like that, and after that I'm just gonna increase a little bit strength of this backlight. Okay, so now here you can see we have a perfect lighting into these object edges, and which is look nice to me. So we'll just increase a little bit more, and we'll just rotate this light little bit more here also, and we'll just move it little bit up. Yeah, so now here you can see that's look nice to me. Yeah, so now I'm just gonna take a render and let's see how it's look like basically. And before doing the render, make sure you just did your render settings. So make sure you enable the render denoising as well, and it's your choice if you want. If you have a good graphic card, so you can enable the viewport. Okay, the viewport denoising as well, otherwise it's not required. And apart from that, you can just change the little volume value 1.28. So now what will happen here, you can see when I'm just gonna take a render. So here you can see it will look something like that. And now here you can see, guys, we have a perfect render here, and which is look nice to me. Okay guys, so that's how you can add the lighting into our scene. And here you can see we have a beautiful render here, and which is look nice to me. And after that you can just save your render, and you can use any kind of photo editing software. You can just do little color correction, okay, and you will see a much better result also. Okay guys, so I hope you enjoy this series and you learn something new today. And if you haven't watched these three previous videos, so make sure you also watch these three videos. So that's it for this tutorial, guys, and thanks for watching this video. Guys, if you learned something in this video, please hit the like button, the share button, and subscribe my channel. Also, if you have any queries, if you have any suggestion, please let me know in the comment box. I will definitely reply comment. So bye bye, take care, and stay home, guys.